Now, once we finish the procedure, we can return the bed to the lowest position for safety, assist that patient in a comfortable position. And again, we may have just suctioned and we were dealing with the patient's airway, so assess to see if the patient's head of bed needs to be just elevated at least past 30 degrees. So assess your patient here. Dispose of all your used equipment. Now's the time to reassess the patient's respiratory status. How did they tolerate that procedure? We can look at their breathing, their pulse ox, for example, and reassess here is key. Now we can remove our gloves, perform our hand hygiene, and of course, document our procedure. So now that we've completed our procedure, make sure you return the bed to the lowest position for safety. Make sure your patient's up in a comfortable position. And again, depending on your patient, because we're talking about airway here, we may need their head of bed up at least 30 degrees. Now we can dispose of all of our used equipment, and this is a great time to reassess the patient's respiratory status. Now we've been in there and trying to do routine care on the airway. We just want to make sure the patient's respiratory status is still stable. Remove your gloves at this point, perform hand hygiene, and make sure, of course, to document the procedure. Thanks for watching, guys. Let's take a look at some possible complications when we're dealing with a tracheostomy or care. So what we don't want to happen is accidental removal of the tube. This is what's protecting the patient's airway. Therefore, when we talk about emergency equipment, it's important to have a tracheostomy tube, a sterile one, on hand if needed. Also, we're going to look for signs and symptoms of infection, especially around that stomacite. So excessive redness, kind of pussy drainage, maybe even low-grade fever that your patient's exhibiting. And again, going back to that skin, guys, and checking that stomacite, sometimes because of excess moisture and maybe the stomacite's really drainy, all of the skin can get really red and irritated. And lastly, aspiration. Because we have an open airway here, the patient can aspirate, further causing complications with breathing. Let's talk about another consideration when we're talking about tracheostomy care. So when we're performing tracheostomy tube care with a patient, as you can imagine, this can often be irritating and can be painful, especially if it's a new trach. It can a lot of the times cause the clients to cough, maybe clear their throat. So as you can imagine, if there's any coughing or movement by the patient, it's really important that you hold on to the tube when, for example, you're providing care. For example, when maybe you're changing those trach ties out or cleaning the trach. Now, if this occurs, if during this care that the patient maybe coughs, make sure you hold on to the tube, give that client a little break, let them reset, and then you can continue completing the procedure.